It's a smaller program. We admit 24 students per class, which allows us to build relationships with the students actually for the 2 years that they're with us. We can become not just their instructors but their mentors as well. We have plenty of access to animals. That's not only the small animals but large animals as well. From right at the beginning, you know, you start hands-on like your first class. We have state-of-the-art equipment. The treatment room is where we do most of our procedures. We learn to do dental cleanings there. All of our surgery prep is done in that room. We have a radiology room. We have a fully functional lab. We do blood work. We do work with urine. The lab also includes our computer station. We have a mock computer system, so the students also get some training on doing the record keeping as well. Beyond that, then, is our kennel area. We have washer and dryer on site. We use a lot of mathematics in veterinary medicine because we do a lot of calculations. We're not talking about advanced calculus, we're talking basic mathematics, but you need to be able to do a story problem, so to speak. You have to be able to do a step-by-step where there's multiple steps to a problem. Scientifically, you have to be curious. If I have this situation, what kind of things might have caused that? So you have to be a critical thinker as well. It's important to remember that most of the animals that we deal with on a daily basis are not happy to see us. They are sick or injured or not in their comfortable environment, so they're scared. They may even be defensive. Our patients are not able to come in and say, this is where it hurts. And so we have to, based on testing, radiographs, blood draws and accepted parameters to determine what the problem is. Lab technician, the x-ray technician, kennel cleanup help, do all of those jobs, plus educate the client on, you know, this is the medication that we're prescribing, this is how to give it, this is what to look for, side effects. You know, these are all things that we need to educate the client on. When they come in with a new animal, it's my responsibility to give them the fundamentals of raising that animal in a safe, healthy environment. We focus on things like nutrition, dental care, things like that. We educate clients on how to do it, when to do it, what to do. That frees up the veterinarian to do the things that they do, which are diagnosing disease, performing surgery, and prescribing medication. As long as they're doing those three things, technicians can do everything else. There are probably 50% of us, maybe even a little higher, are gonna work in small animal practice. The other 40% work in areas like wildlife. They work in zoo settings. There's the military hires technicians. There's technicians that work for the government in food safety, for example. Technicians can also work in specialty centers. There's everything from dental specialty to orthopedic surgery, internal medicine, you know, a variety of specialties that you can work in. Industry is a big place. If you are interested in applying, the applications are accepted January 1st through March 1st. We have a minimum standard for math and science scores. And then each student that successfully makes it to that point undergoes an interview. That's an opportunity to have a conversation and make sure that they understand what they're getting into before they make that commitment.